Hello and welcome back. This time we're going to talk about a combined controller type. With that, the B controller reacts fast at the beginning and in the end it does not care. With that, the I controller does not care in the beginning and in the end it is very accurate. Hey, why don't combine those two elements? Why don't combine those two things to a so-called PI controller? And this is exactly how it is done. PI controller. PI controller are very, very common type of controllers. Basically, they are a parallel of P controller and I controller. So the transfer function FRPI is the sum of a proportional controller plus and now the integrational controller. So we end up at KP, this was the transfer function, plus, and now the transfer function of the I controller, 1 divided by STO. And of course, exactly when we talked about the PI element, we're going to get out KP here, so usually it's written KP 1 plus 1 divided by STN. And TN was TO multiplied by KP. This is the transfer function of a PI controller. PI element. Those are the two parts I can adjust. This is a combination then of a fast P controller at the beginning and an accurate I controller at the end. This is a good combination for a controller, and this is why it's used very, very regularly in a lot of applications. PI controller is basically the controller of a first combined controller. Two things usually adjustable, KP and TN. Advantage is clear, combines the advantage of a P and a I controller. Sometimes leads to instability. This is why our next controller type is used in our next video. And we're also going to combine two controller types exactly the same like we did here. But it's again a P and the other one is different. Phew, I hope I have not said too much already and you know everything. However, hear you next time. This time, thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.